interpretations of the floating forest, which is something that enchanted me upon first coming to this gallery. And I thought, wow, wouldn't it be cool to do something earthy-themed around this? And so Graham and I got talking, and this came together as a concert. And I invited Emily Shapiro on bass clarinet and Jess Hort on clarinet to come and play this concert of improvisations, interpretations, and works for winds. So we're going to split this into three sets. And I invite you also to move around the room with us. We're going to start on this side of the wall, which is more busier, detailed, leafy stuff. And then in the second section, we're going to move across to here, where the tones are a little bit more like autumn or something, which is what we're entering now. And then we're going to finish on this wall. So there's going to be a little bit of shifting, but there's going to be breaks in between. But a short note is that every set will be through composed, so there won't be any breaks between pieces and improvisations. So if you can hold your applause till the end. And so we're going to start with a group improvisation inspired by the work with some poetry, and then followed by a piece that Emily will be playing on bass clarinet.
So the piece I'm playing is called Smindaugamerto by Evan Ziporyn. I'll just show it to you because it's complicated to spell and say. Evan Ziporyn wrote this originally for himself to play. It's a transcription of a very old Orthodox, Georgian Orthodox hymn, and you sing through the instrument as you're playing the entire time, and the first bit is all drones, and then the second bit is more contrapuntal, and it's very cool, and I think it's one of my favorite solo pieces to play, and one of the things I like best about it is that it's this very ancient piece, this very ancient composition that's being realized with a very contemporary technique.
We follow on with a piece for solo piccolo, which is something I never thought I would be doing, because solo piccolo is a little bit, it's very in front of your face, but one of my favorite composers is Kaija, Saariaho. She's Finnish, and she incorporates the use of voice and flute. So one thing I really love doing is speaking and incorporating the voice in how I play. And I think this kind of is a bit of a dialogue in the pieces that we've chosen. They incorporate the voice somehow. And so I chose that. And then we're going to finish with a piece that Emily has written.
Yep. So this is a structured improvisation. It doesn't have a name yet. It's kind of a workshopping of two composition ideas. So probably eventually these will both become traditionally composed works, but right now we're playing with them. And the middle section is based on birdsong. It was a story that I heard on a podcast last night that I just thought was one of the most, just really, really sad, but also really interesting, and I really wanted to interpret it musically. So there's a kind of bird that's native to Hawaii that went extinct. I got my ideas wrong, probably early, mid-1900s, due to mostly disease. It was hunted a little bit for its feathers, but mostly disease. And they, around the time that it went extinct, there was one mated pair for a while. They mated for life. And there had been a hurricane, and the female was not seen again. But they did see the male one more time, and they caught a sound recording of it. And he was, the person who got the sound recording was really excited to have gotten it and played the recording back, and the bird immediately came back and sang again. And he realized that it was because this bird had not heard another bird sound of its kind in a really long time, and would probably never again. And so you can sort of hear one half of what's intended to be a duet. So I sort of quickly transcribed roughly some of the sounds that I heard, and I thought, we would play this kind of as a duet together in the middle of this piece. So I'm really excited to try that out.
Yeah, please enjoy the first set.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So how are you finding it?
This is on record.
It's okay.
It's great. As in the artwork, ourselves?
As in the space, the evening. Chosen that wall for this next part.
It's dry and it reminds me of Australia in some regards. So I'll explain. But this next piece is it uses fixed media. So this is something called the samples. Wow, I just forgot a word. I should try.
I don't know the word. Is there
sound field recordings. Field recordings. Field recordings of Strabra. Australia. It's an island off Queensland. Does everyone know where Queensland is? It's okay. So Australia has two ears, and it's the eastern ear, and it's the top half of that ear. And so I went and did around a 5-day residency there, and I had to write a work. I wanted to too. And Strabo Island, the traditional owners, it's called Majeraba, and it was culminating in an exhibition of visual art and also sonic art. And I decided at that time I was very, very interested in field recordings, so going around and listening to dawn chorus, the ocean, people walking on the sand, and recording almost every little sound that intrigued me, and then meshing it into fixed media. And very interesting things happen on this island. I lost my phone in a sand dune after running down with great excitement and glee. I felt my pockets and lost my my phone, and I had to then consequently borrow a metal detector from a local, this is all true, a local artist. And I then went up the sand dune again to try and find this phone. And the metal detector actually inspired a huge part of this piece, because it sings when it finds certain types of metals. And it would, you know, do one particular pitch if it found iron, found aluminium, it would do another one. And sometimes this strange symphony of blips and bloops would happen when it found a mixed metal. So this, it's in five movements. The first part is called pre-dawn ablutions. And then we've got building bridges, because they actually wanted to build a lot of infrastructure on the island, and this would have obstructed a lot of activity. The south part of the island is actually used for mining minerals and making glass, and the north part of the island is still quite pristine and beautiful. And then we've also got Legacy of Ill-Placed Tracks, which is the name of the work, and then Bird Baths and Precious Metals, which is about me losing my phone in the sand dune, and then Hydrothermals, which is an interesting occurrence of when I was walking in the water, there were patches where the sand was really cold and then really warm straight after, and that was all the activity happening underneath the island, just the water underneath. So please enjoy Legacy of Ill-Placed Tracks.
Thank you.
forest, set to some poetry, and then we're moving to a bit of a treasure that we found on the internet, which can be a bit rare, called Noems, and some selected movements from that by Anna Habkovjanyan. Yes. And
Noems is Greek for breath.
Yes, Greek breath.
Greek.
And I couldn't find all that much on her, but that this piece is written ritualistically. I think it follows ritual, church ritual and things. And it's the harmonies are quite crunchy and nice. It's a bit of a treat for the ears. And then we're going to go into a piece which a friend of mine and I have been working on. Well, we were both very passionate about something other than music, and that was the environment and the state of the environment as it is now, and the need to address the climate crisis. There's no really blunt way to put it. And I commissioned her to write a piece, and she chose my favourite speech, the speech by Greta Thunberg, I Want You to Panic, this House is on Fire speech. And when I received it, I did panic a bit, because the musical material is so intense. It really, by the end of it, you really, really feel breathless, and you feel like you've been battling, which I guess when you see her speak, you can feel that she feels like she just wants to break through this brick wall. And this piece is, I think, very important. I've played it in various places around, and it's going to be an ongoing project, hopefully a means to an end, where this piece will just be a memory rather than a battle. And then we go into our final piece, which is Jess.
A piece called Matins and Loves, and it's for clarinet and humming audience. So you'll all receive a bit of a note, an instruction, if you want to call it that. And yeah, I absolutely love this piece. I haven't played it in about 5 years, and it's been an absolute delight. Playing it again tonight, so I hope you enjoy.
Yeah. And yeah, we'll all end with a bit of a humming meditation, I think, or a tuning meditation in the style of Paulina Oliveros together, and you're welcome to continue humming after Jess concludes her piece, and we'll finish in that spirit of, just listening to each other and being in the space. Yeah, please enjoy the third section.
Thank you.
shall return.
Success stories, but say financial success has come with an unthinkable price tag. And on climate change, we have to acknowledge that we have failed. We have to acknowledge that we have failed. the climate crisis is the greatest challenge that Homo sapiens have ever faced. The main solution, however, is so simple that even a child can understand it.
Now,
we